Well, not so sure about born congressman, but Sidhu certainly seems to be a born politician with the complete turnaround that he's done. Fabulous panel we have tonight. R.P. Singh, National Secretary of the BJP, joins us. Our Rajgopalan, senior journalist, is with us here in the Delhi studios. Shahid Siddiqui will be joining us very, very shortly. Kumar Ketkar, senior journalist, is with us. Tehsin Poolawala, political analyst, is also with us. And senior journalist Saba Naqvi as well. Tehsin, the interesting thing about this, it's not new. Political opportunism is not new. Party hopping is not new. Jumping ship is not new. But what's really interesting about this particular development is that Navjot Singh Sidhu seems to have joined hands with the Congress as a last resort. He tried everything. He tried talking to the Aam Aadmi Party. He's floated his own political front, which he seems to have very quietly buried now. And when nothing else seemed to work out, he went to the Congress, a party that he has been virtually abusing for years. And the Congress happily lapped it up. If this isn't political opportunism, what is?
The Prime Minister of our country in Kashmir said, Baap Beti Ki Sarkar.
Baap Beti Speak ki about sarkar. Congress.
Sir, I have not
Speak
in,
about
sir, let's
Congress.
Have some manners on the debate and
Speak
please do
about
not
Congress.
Okay, so Tehsin,
yes. So the fact is, I understand that he's a BJP spokesman.
No, you are a Congress, but you know, speak about Congress.
The fact of the
matter
is,
she is not Prime Minister here.
The last debate was about trolls, not this debate.
Tehsin, so why don't you answer the question?
The fact of the matter is, the Prime Minister goes to Kashmir, criticizes Mufti Saab, the late Mufti Saab, and forms a government with him. Half of the Prime Minister's people in Assam were ex-congressmen. Rita Baguna Joshi, like you all rightly said,
Absolutely.
Joins the Congress.
No
after
doubt about
all
it.
That she told the Prime Minister in her tweets, and I can read them out, but let's not get into that.
No,
the
no, and we will.
Is,
I have those, yes, I
no,
have those statements here.
Details,
but I'd like to know your
the
views on the Congress
now,
taking in
now,
Sidhu into their fold after
absolutely.
The kind of things that he said.
I'm,
Pappu Prime Minister for Manmohan Singh. Rahul Gandhi needs to go back to school. You know, all
these.
Now, yeah, respond to that.
Debate on trolls. Now the fact of the matter is Sidhu is a vote getter. Sidhu has his influence in Amritsar and in those pockets. The Congress is winning Punjab, and as Captain Saab rightly said, we have to do what it takes to win. And as Sidhu rightly said, it is the resurrection of Punjab. This is a very important election for Punjab. The youth of Punjab today are suffering. We need to bring them out of their suffering, their misery, their poverty, bring in investment. Sidhu is a brand ambassador in sorts of Punjab. And what is wrong if he comes into the Congress?
So,
and like he rightly
so
said.
So you're saying he's a vote getter, he's popular.
Absolutely.
And this is redemption time for Punjab.
Just as
no,
it was
no,
so
look, Tina,
so
the Congress needs him.
Yeah, yeah, but Tina, just want to ask Tehsin there, who's in the studios
yes,
with
ma'am.
You. Tehsin, this is Tanvi here from the Mumbai studio. You say what's
Hi,
wrong if Sidhu joins the Congress party? It's just a little difficult, and I'm sure the viewers and the voters will also struggle with this. Case in point is what he said in 2013 in an interview to a newspaper. Modi ji is my role model. He's out to make a difference in the people's lives, and he is a development driven chief minister. Look at what he's done in Gujarat. And he goes on and on, Tehsin, in this interview, praising Modi ji, praising BJP's ideologies. And we can give you five other instances between then and now. Very recent ones, some of those we played out, Tehsin, where he's become extremely personal about Congress leaders, you know, and he's made very, very personal remarks about senior leaders, including a former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, and then about Rahul Gandhi. Now, has Congress, can the Congress party really forgive and forget all of that just because in Amritsar East, Sidhu can do wonders for the
what
party? Has the party
show?
Come to that
on.
Desperate levels now that you can forgive and forget all of that?
Tanvi, what does this show? It shows two things. First of all, to your last comment, has the party come to desperate levels? Let me say this, the Congress is winning Punjab. No two ways about it, and you'll be surprised with the results. But on a larger point, when the government in the center can continue with the Kashmir government after Burhan Wani is given awards, this government says one thing on nationalism, does another thing. When that hypocrisy, these are personal
He's
attacks,
and
it shows, and it shows, and it shows that the fact is that the Congress has a, it shows that the Congress has a larger heart. It shows that the Congress has a larger heart. It shows that the Congress is speaking out here on ideology. It shows that the attacks are not personal.
If you say larger heart,
and it talks, and it talks about the development of the
larger heart. Then that larger heart applies to
today, when we talk about the development of Punjab, that is the priority. The priority is getting those youth jobs. The priority is getting investment in. The priority is getting Punjab, resurrecting Punjab. That is the priority.
And Sidhu assures
and personal
that.
Attacks. And personal attacks is unfortunate in politics,
yes,
should be less aside,
okay,
and we should work towards a better Punjab, a better India, a Modi-mukt India.
But you know, the point is, and as Tanvi said, you know, Modi was Sidhu's role model at one point. The turnarounds are quite, they're astounding in politics. But Sabha Naqvi, I'd like to get you in. There's some very serious allegations and serious things that he's also said about the Congress party. It's not just about, you know, things like those extremely derogatory words like Pappu, PM or Rahul should go back to school. I'm just, you know, bringing our viewers' attention to what Navjot Singh Sidhu said in 2005 in relation to the 1984 killings. And he said that he refused to have his team introduce, the cricket team he was talking about, introduced to Jagdish Taitler, a member of the Congress party, because of his role allegedly in the 1984 riots. And as per his own claims, he says he was the only BJP MP who regularly joined the Shiromani Akali Dal MPs in staging walkouts from parliament every single time any of the Congress ministers accused of engineering the anti-Sikh riots rose to speak. These are serious things that he said about the Congress party, Sabha.
Yeah, absolutely. So, Tina, you've hit the nail bang on. I think the toughest to jump party is not the issue, but Sidhu's political misadventure or journey, adventure, whatever you want to call it, has actually been something quite amazing. I've never witnessed something like this. He walked out of a Rajya Sabha seat in the BJP. He almost joined the Aam Aadmi Party. It is said he wanted to be chief ministerial candidate. It is said he dragged on with the Congress because there also he wanted to be chief ministerial candidate, and various, whatever it is. But right now, let's on the lighter note, we have an election where there are three prominent comedians. There's Navjot Singh Sidhu, there's Bhagwat Mann, there is a gentleman called Guggi, I think. two of them are from Aam Aadmi Party, one of them is from Congress. So we are not going to be short on humor. I think all of us should put all this aside and understand we'll get lots of jokes in Punjab. Having said so, you have a very good point about Sidhu's statements on the Congress involvement in the 1984 riots. And these are valid considerations. These are things we must all, we must debate it. I mean, how, this is pretty shameful actually, you know, that an individual can jump like this, go around and then pretend to be, then say ghar vapsi. It's pretty shameful. Whether it works or not is not the point. It is one of those disgraceful political journeys, the way I see it.
Absolutely, Sabha. In fact, you know, and I want to discuss that more, and I'll go across to Shahid Siddiqui and Mr. Kumar Ketkar in just a bit. But R.P. Singh has been responding to a couple of comments that have been made here. R.P. Singh, now there's a lot of confidence on the other side of the camp that Congress is going to win these elections and Sidhu is going to do those wonders. Is BJP then regretting that they have lost out on Sidhu?
See, we all know that in Punjab election, Congress is a sinking ship. And they would cling on to anything which can help them today. I mean, they that's why they don't mind clinging on to a turncoat also. And we all know Sidhu is a big confused guy and egoistic too. His last few months have shown that he's quite confused. And his ego comes every time he speaks, his ego speaks out. But the issue is bigger than this. Issue is... is Sidhu going to speak in favor of Congress? I mean, till yesterday, he used to speak of Mother India, and today he will speak of Mother Sonia Gandhi. I mean, what he should speak there in Punjab today?
Yeah, R.P. Singh, R.P. Singh, you know, confused, we'll I agree with. March. Confused, I agree with, but when
give
you
me
say,
minute, give me a minute, give me,
talk
Tina,
about
give me
John
Coates. Give me, Tina, allow me to complete,
yeah,
please allow me to complete,
come on.
Allow me to make my first statement,
allow me to make my first statement,
allow me to complete. Please,
okay,
Tina.
Yeah, conclude your point. Tessie wants to come in and rebut you on something you've said.
Please allow me to complete.
Go ahead. 4th March,
we'll prove that Navjot Singh Sidhu cannot win his own seat from Amritsar. I'm telling you, I'm giving a challenge to Congress people today.
Okay, now that challenge has been thrown. Tehsin says Congress is winning. You're saying no chance of that. But Tehsin, and I want to bring the others in also. Yeah, so very quickly, because the issue of turncoats, the fact is that if the Congress has been opportunistic, so has the BJP. And we've seen many such examples in the recent past. We'll get all your reactions on that. Yes, Tehsin, very
so
quickly.
So turncoats, we're all aware of, right from Bhaguna Joshi to Hemanto Biswas to half the BJP Lok Sabha MPs. So we are aware of that. Let's not get there. Since he spoke about confused, let me just explain something to him. confusion is when you sit on your seat till the last minute. He had a Rajya Sabha nominated by the president, given to him by the prime minister on a platter. I don't think the man is confused. He was very clear he wants to contest an election. He made that absolutely clear. Where he was getting the opportunity, he was clear. He saw the Congress is winning. Now, you can call these whatever adjectives you want. The fact of the matter is, where you see confusion, and I understand the BJP is in confusion, just like it's in confusion whether Burhan is a terrorist or no.
But you know,
similarly, I think you, I see the...
Rajagopalan, yeah, exactly. What was happening with Aam Aadmi Party? What was happening with Awaaz-e Punjab? What was the whole purpose? Yeah, Rajagopalan,
please. He went and talked to Aam Aadmi Party. With everyone. Today also he did not criticize BJP. Today he criticized Amarendra Singh. He says if Amarendra Singh becomes chief minister, he may also be a candidate.
You know, Sidhu versus captain is another story altogether.
BJP in 2019.
No, we'll come to that.
He's a turncoat. He may not stay with Congress.
Just how well Navjot Singh Sidhu and Captain Amarendra are going to be able to work together is a different debate.
But everyone says he has a chief minister candidate.
On this point of confusion,
he's a threat to Congress.
On this
there.
Point of confusion, Kumar Ketkar, is there any doubt that there has been some massive confusion regarding Navjot Singh Sidhu, because he was talking to the Aam Aadmi Party? We all know that those discussions were on. Then the Awaaz-e Punjab front was floated, which seems to have just kind of dissipated. Is there any doubt about the fact that the Congress has been some sort of last resort for Navjot Singh Sidhu?
Well, all the instances that you are giving are clear indications that Sidhu wanted to leave BJP. And whether he was trying AAP or whether he was trying Congress or whether he was trying to be independent with his wife, all the indications are or were that he is fed up with the BJP. So the question should not be merely asked, is Congress opportunistic or Sidhu opportunistic? Why is such a person, such a flamboyant person like Sidhu, who according to them doesn't matter, is a turncoat and a villain, why BJP could not retain him and why BJP used him to condemn Congress? So BJP found that he is useful to condemn Congress and retained him. So the question remains is that why did he feel like leaving BJP and join Congress? He clearly feels that Modi is on decline and BJP is on decline. That's why he left. Sidhu would not have left.
Mr. Ketkar, the one thing that Sidhu has been saying from day one, he wasn't being given an opportunity to fight in Punjab on his own terms. Now, one would say that he was perhaps confused and Congress was his last resort. What if this all through
Congress
this
was not the plan his last resort
for him to come here on his own
as
terms and conditions? He wanted to fight from a specific seat. He's gotten that. He went around forum shopping.
But just now she said that she was trying even AAP. So Congress was not the last resort. If AAP had given him some promise, he would have retained there. So the question is not of loyalty. Question is not of turncoat. Why he became a turncoat? The question is because Modi is on decline.
Who believes a candidate like that, Mr. Ketkar, if four weeks and three weeks before,
if BJP was strong, Sidhu would not have left. Because he's a turncoat, he's an opportunist. So he would have seen the opportunity by remaining in BJP.
No, it's not because
the
of that. Because he was lured by Aam Aadmi to be projected as chief minister. He got into that lurement of Mr. Kejriwal, saying that he'll be projected as chief minister.
He formed his own party.
His opportunism proves who is weak and who is getting stronger.
Whether it was with AAP, whether it was with
Awaaz-e Punjab,
or whether it is with the Congress,
who is getting weaker and who is getting stronger.
He was absolutely desperate to get out of the BJP, and as Talbi pointed out, that's because the BJP was not giving him what he needed, what he wanted, what he felt he deserved.
He
was
would not have left
to
if BJP
terms.
Was strong.
So can I elaborate?
RP Singh.
He would not leave BJP. He would
so let me can I elaborate?
Let's go to the other. RP Singh and then someone else.
Can I make a small comment?
Yes, RP Singh, very quickly, because the allegation is that the BJP failed to retain him and it's their loss.
Perfect. Let me answer you.
Yes, Abba,
he
1 minute. Just
to be the chief minister, and we have alliance with the Kaladal. So he said, give me a minute, sir. He wanted to be chief minister, and he was lured by Mr. Kejriwal, saying that he'll make him a chief minister. Later on, he was jumped by Mr. Kejriwal. His ambition is to be the chief minister. Even in Congress, he is going as the chief minister. He has been committed by Priyanka Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi that after election, we'll dump Captain Amrinder Singh and make you chief minister. He's going on in this government. So, and that's what I say. Wait till 4th March.
RP Singh, that's the question we'll ask the other side, RP Singh. But is BJP now finding it very convenient to say, oh, he's a turncoat?
Can I?
What happened when you got a Ritu Bhagwan Joshi, who also Congress now calls a turncoat?
No.
It's not the BJP. It's not like the BJP hasn't gone ahead and brought leaders of the other political parties just before the elections. So why use this convenience argument today,
I never used the word turncoat. I said he's a confused, egoistic person. Okay. I said he's a confused, egoistic person. That's why he went for a allurement by Mr. Kejriwal. From there he formed his own party. From there he joined Congress.
You all the issue is that
he wants to become the chief minister. And I'm telling you,
campaign,
moment the election is over, he was Congress loses the election, he'll start abusing Congress.
But
because Congress is not going to support him as the next CM candidate.
But he was your star speaker, star campaigner against Congress. Yeah. So why did you allow such an egotist and confused person to lead your party?
Can I all the respect by Sanjeev Tiwari Sabha?
Such an egotist and confused person to campaign for your party.
Top committee of Punjab.
Singh Saab.
We need to just bring in Shahid Siddiqui. I haven't gotten Tehsin and Sabha coming to you. Tehsin and Sabha coming to you. Yeah, give me a minute. I need to bring in Shahid Siddiqui. Shahid Siddiqui. Shahid Siddiqui. Now, the fact is that Navjot Singh Sidhu is somebody who has had the choicest of words for the Congress party, for Rahul Gandhi, for Manmohan Singh over the years. It's not new to politics. You know, somebody jumping ship is not new to politics. But is this a really peculiar and very, very special episode that has happened, as Sabha Naqvi pointed out? Because we've actually seen Navjot Singh Sidhu jump from one spot to the other. It's been hop, skip, jump from leaving his Rajya Sabha seat to going and talking to the Aam Aadmi Party to trying to figure out what to do with Awaaz Punjab, and then finally coming to the Congress and actually having the cheek to come out and say, I'm a born Congressee. Who's going to believe that, Shahid Siddiqui?
No, it's not. He's not the first political leader to do that. That has always been happening. Azam Khan, who was extremely critical of Mulayam Singh, went back. Amar Singh, who was calling Mulayam Singh all names, went back to him. Rita Bhagwan Joshi, who was the face of Congress, condemning BJP, fighting BJP, went to BJP. So this has been happening. He is not the first person. Let's not condemn him. But he is a very egoistic person, no doubt. His ego was hurt in BJP. For him, more important than chief minister's post or a political position is his ego. And his ego was hurt when he was denied Amritsar seat, when he was denied importance in the alliance. And I think he has been feeling left out all through, in spite of the fact that he was given Rajya Sabha seat.
Accepted the Rajya Sabha thereafter.
He went out from there and he was waiting to see which side. Now let me speak. I've been hearing you. Please listen
yes,
to me.
Yes, go ahead, Mr.
Let
Siddiqui.
Me speak. You can speak after me. Now, so he saw which side the wind is blowing. He was waiting because let me be honest. Today in Punjab, the battle is between Congress and Aam Aadmi Party. Akali BJP alliance is in the third position. Everybody knows that in Punjab. BJP will get very angry. They will not accept it. But you can't help ostrich if it doesn't want to see the reality. The reality is, Sidhu could see it. And Sidhu was waiting to see which party was gaining ground. And he has realized that Congress
Siddiqui,
is gaining ground. And he can go along with Congress.
Mr.
So
Siddiqui, is it just about what Sidhu thinks, where he's gaining ground? Or is it about what he's gaining out of it? Is it about the point that was raised earlier on this debate of whether he can be given the chief minister profile and made the CM candidate?
Sidhu,
because that wouldn't have happened with the Akalis or the BJP. That definitely didn't happen.
No, I don't think any of these two parties would have made him the chief minister.
He's still pushing
it
with Congress.
Knows that.
I don't think Captain Amrinder is going to give that
BJP a lesson. Sidhu wanted to tell BJP that if you did not respect me, I will show you.
Yes. So for a man who said
dismissalship.
Savanakni, for a man who said jo 60
more important
jo 60 years
position whatever I know
jo 60 saal tak aapko dhoka dete rahe jo aapko 60 saal vishwasghat karte rahe unka vishwas kaise rahenge. That is what Sidhu had to once upon a time in 2013 say about the Congress party. Yes, Mr. Rajgopalan, coming to you, 1 minute.
A question to Savanakni,
therefore Rahul Gandhi was confused.
Just coming to come
on, my question is to take him in the
clearly still seems to be chasing
because he wants
how does anybody believe he will even survive in this current role?
I can't hear anything.
Yeah, Sabha, my question is that if he doesn't get the CM post here,
I can't hear anything. But let me just say,
before the election,
as someone who knows,
go ahead.
Who knows what exactly happened? My friend from the BJP is absolutely right. It's a comedy what Sidhu has been doing in the last few months. Let's face it, everybody knows, we all of us who know people in the BJP who covered it. I went to Amritsar during the Lok Sabha election. Everybody knew that he was annoyed with the fact that Mr. Arun Jaitley was given the seat, and he just didn't like the situation. Frankly, the BJP gave him a Rajya Sabha, which is pretty good. They got him into the parliament. But he had notions, he actually thought he would be chief minister. And so did his wife. And they jumped the gun, and the wife was talking about him being the CM possibility for the Aam Aadmi Party when they have a rule that husband, members of the same family can't be it. So they made a comedy ring. I mean, let's be frank, but they've been going round and round in circles. Here is a man who was a cricketer, who hosted a comedy show, who wanted to become chief minister in one party. Then he wanted to become chief minister in the Congress, so he dragged it out till the very end. So the whole thing, frankly, to me is absurd. I agree that people jump parties all the time. I don't know whether Sidhu will be of any use, but frankly, as a political observer, I have rarely seen someone so desperately
saying,
I want to be
Gina Madam,
I'm this great guy.
No,
it's interesting that Sabha says that, you know, it's been bizarre the way he's gone about this, whereas Shahid Siddiqui says that Navjot Singh Sidhu, in fact, has been the smartest about this, because he's kind of waited and watched and seen who's gaining ground and who's going to give him what, and then decided to go with this. So that's an interesting point. But Mr. Rajgopalan, you know, when you talk about the fact that the Congress party accepts him despite the kind of statements that he has made against them in the past, I ask you, when Rita Bahuguna Joshi joined the BJP, the Congress called her an opportunist leader and said that opportunistic leaders don't stick to one place. Now the fact is that Rita Bahuguna Joshi, if she joined the BJP, then was the BJP being opportunistic or was she being opportunistic? But that question arises.
She also criticized Rahul Gandhi. Therefore, here Tamudar Singh Sidhu is not criticizing BJP leaders. He is only criticizing Amarendra Singh.
Is that fair? Is that fair, Tehsin?
He is criticizing only Amarendra Singh.
Okay, so Tehsin,
he does not criticize
the fact
BJP.
Is that he has come out
and BJP in 2019.
Sidhu has actually come out and he's been very critical of the Shiromani Akali Dal and the Badals. But he has not actually been critical of the BJP.
All right, so now if I may speak. The fact of the matter is, whatever everyone out here is saying, one thing is clear. Whatever adjectives you use for Sidhu, whether you call him an opportunist, whether you call him that he's egoistic, the fact of the matter was the BJP pandered to him for 10 years, 15 years. The fact of the matter is, when he was upset, they gave him the Rajya Sabha. He quit his Rajya Sabha. He was very clear what he wanted. Whether those goals of his...
Why did he accept it?
Ma'am, please. Let's have some discipline.
Why did he accept it?
Whether those goals are realistic or no, the fact is he was very clear on his goals, as according to all the neutral observers. If he's very clear, he can't be confused. Point number one. Point number two, it's very interesting when you talk to Singh Saab or you talk to any of the neutral supporters like Rajagopalan ji, who actually appear like BJP spokesman.
Yeah,
they know everything. They speak about everything.
There is nothing wrong in it.
They speak about the...
You have won your allegiance to Congress.
They speak about...
Are you a congressman? You tell me.
They speak about...
Are you a congressman?
Okay.
Please do not touch me.
Okay.
They speak about the AAP. They speak about the AAP internal politics. They speak about the AAP internal...
Why do you speak about Congress?
They speak about the AAP internal politics. They speak about the Congress decision making. But the fact is, nobody's speaking about what the BJP is doing or what the AAP is doing. The fact of the matter is, Navjot Singh Sidhu had a goal. His goal, he says, is the development of Punjab. He says he does not believe in personalized politics. He does not believe
Your point being that absolutely. He has his goals, and if his means to an end for his goals, fine. So,
madam, these goals are misplaced.
Are they?
Why did he accept
RP Singh, a whole string of party jumpers. You know, the BJP took on Rita Bahuguna Joshi. The BJP, when we look at what's been happening in Uttarakhand, you know, absolutely everyone starting. In Uttarakhand, starting from Satpal Maharaj to, you know, Chaudhary Biren Singh. Now, of course, again, you have had, you know, an entire bunch moving across with Yashpal Arya also. What's happening
Arunachal
there?
The point is that everybody
indulges in this opportunism, RP Singh.
I never use word opportunism. I use word, he's a confused egoistic. I use that word. Opportunism is but used by others. And yes, he was looking for an opportunity to be the chief minister of Punjab. And we can't give him an opportunity because we have a tie with the Akalis. And he knew that we have a tie with the Akalis.
So he was not egoistic when you made him a candidate to Namrata, he was egoistic even at that time.
Allow me to complete, sir. And also that he wanted to join the Aam Aadmi Party because he was lured by Mr. Kejriwal that I'll make you the chief minister, which he couldn't fulfill, which he dumped him later on. And late, after that, he made his own party, thinking that there are a lot of people who follow him. And again, that he couldn't get response, so he jumped to Congress bandwagon. And Congress want to cling on to anything which can save them today, and which can save the sinking ship. And mark my word, on 4th March, we'll sit here, and I'll tell you that Sidhu will lose belt in his home constituency this time.
But the point here is, RP Singh, and the point that Kumar Kesar was also raising is... Why did he leave the BJP in the first place? For 10 years, you didn't think he was confused, or that he was just chasing power of some kind.
If he was so confused and he was a joker.
He was given Rajya Sabha by Narendra Modi ji himself and was made part of the core committee of Punjab, which takes decision on Punjab.
And yet he resigned. His target is to be the chief minister. He can't achieve that within BJP because he was aligned with Akali.
And he has stayed in that alliance for 15 years.
He resigned, and therefore it proves that he is fed up with the BJP. He went to Aam Aadmi Party with the same target, but he was jumped again on decline. Yeah. If he did not find BJP and Modi on decline, he would have never left because he is an egotist. He would have survived. And in BJP, only one person is allowed to be egotist. That is Narendra Modi himself. Nobody else. In every political party, there is an egotist. Kejriwal is an egotist. Narendra Modi is an egotist.
Mr. Kejriwal, I'm sorry, sir. You are not aware of the political system.
In your party, only one person is allowed to be egotist. All others are supposed to subsume their egos. Entire cabinet of the BJP subsumes their egos. Okay, I have a question for you also, Mr. Kedkarnav, before we go across. I'm not defending Congress. I'm merely saying the fact that Sidhu is leaving BJP, joining Congress, means he feels that BJP and Modi are in decline. Whatever Sidhu has done can be comedy, can be opportunism.
No, he didn't leave BJP. He left BJP. I'm not questioning all the attributes. But what we are discussing tonight is the politics of opportunism. And a lot of people have tagged this as opportunism. It's not just Sidhu. You know what happened in 2015?
That BJP does not see opportunity in BJP.
In 2015 January, when Jayanti Natarajan, Mr. Kedkar, and I want to take this to the other panelists, when she left the Congress party, the entire Congress party turned around and said, oh, she's being opportunistic. In the same breath, then now, is the Congress being opportunistic or not?
That's what I'm saying. All these people who
changed. When Hemanta Biswa Sarma left and joined the BJP ahead of the Assam elections.
But who is defending Congress or BJP?
No, so I'm putting the question because we are discussing the politics of opportunism and how prevalent it is.
The fact that somebody who is an opportunist leaves the party means he is seeing opportunity somewhere else. That is why he is an opponent.
Okay,
all
that time, all that time.
So it's okay. It's okay if you get all the opportunities.
Jayanti Natarajan, Rita Bhagwat's thought.
Point taken. I just want to take it to the other side.
Opportunities on that side.
Why did he join BJP?
Jayanti, you wanted to make a point. Is it okay to get opportunities when they're joining the Congress party? But when they're abandoning the Congress party, which is Hemanta Biswa Sarma or Jayanti Natarajan, then you have the worst of the description for those leaders.
I'll just answer that. There's just a little difference in the examples you gave and Sidhu. All the examples you gave fulfilled their tenure as ministers. They enjoyed the perks as ministers. Sidhu, on the other hand, resigned the Rajya Sabha just given to him because he was very clear on what he wanted. Which is exactly the point that I'm trying to make.
And not to join Congress, he Jayanti, never left.
Whether you're talking about Rita Bhagwat Joshi, whether you're talking about Hemanta Biswas, they enjoyed the perks of being
intentionally missing the legs.
In this particular case, this man resigned something that's given to him on a platter, and he's very clear this is his goal for Punjab. He's very clear the resurrection of Punjab, and he's come to the Congress. Point number two.
Why the Congress accepted?
One second, coming to you.
And since
Mr. Gopal, years he has been abusing Congress only.
No, that's true. One second, I just Sabha coming to you. Mr. Rajgopalan, please. I want to respond to what Tehsin has said, because while you say that people, you know, who came out of these plush posts, whether it was PCC president, whether it was a cabinet berth or whatever, they also left the Congress on extremely sour notes. Yes. Let me remind you, they left the Congress party having really terrible things to say about the leadership, about Rahul Gandhi. Yes, Sabha.
Your observations on that.
Yeah, Sabha, please.
You know, just one point. Yes, I want to just ask Tehsin one thing. Can we have, as an analyst, everybody knows that the Congress is going for a generation change eventually. Rahul Gandhi will become the face eventually. He has a problem with the old guard. Amrinder Singh is the old guard. There has been a suggestion that there have been editorials written on how delayed the Congress list for Punjab was. Are we sure that Sidhu is not some kind of stalking horse? I'm just throwing it up there. Because Amrinder Singh is 75 years old. We know he does not get along with the next generation of Congress. So they're all living with each other. So, does it actually solve problems or does it create problems? I'm asking you a straightforward question.
Somebody who also analyzes, I would rather have a problem of plenty rather than a problem of of not having any players on my bench, using a cricket analogy. Since Sidhu is a cricketer, I'd rather have a bench that has reserves who are good enough to get into the playing 11, come out there and perform. And why not? And point number two, I'd rather have a team where every of the person is a performer rather than the team today that we're seeing of Modi and Amit Shah, where it's I, me, myself, and cabinet ministers don't know demonetization is taking place. So a problem of plenty in politics, according to me, is a good problem rather than a negative problem.
Where is the plenty?
Whether Sidhu is that or not, I'm not aware of it.
Mr. Rajgopalan, yes, you know, he's smiling away while you're talking. Where is the problem of plenty, Mr. Rajgopalan, that has joined the Congress? There are literally truckloads who are leaving the Congress and joining the BJP.
Because Amarinder Singh himself is not welcoming Mr. Sidhu. Amarinder Singh said Sidhu is a joker. Only last week he said.
Tehsin, respond to that.
In fact,
week he said.
You know, in the world of social media, you may be. In today's age, a week is very behind. As a lifetime in politics, you may behave like a troll, but the fact of the matter is, Captain Arminder's last interview 2 days ago or 3 days ago, and even yesterday, said very clear to all the major publications and news channels that whatever the Congress party chooses, whatever is in the best interest of the party, he will stick by it as a loyal soldier of the party. He's very clear on record on that. Point number two, he's very clear whatever it takes for Congress to win Punjab and resurrect Punjab, that needs to be done. Sidhu needs to resurrect Punjab. If these two forces
can resurrect Punjab,
then the interest of Punjab, the interest of India must come paramount.
Can they work together? That's the question.
Congress has not identified Chief Minister of Punjab. Sidhu is a Chief Minister. I'll answer that in one second.
Has BJP given a face in Uttar Pradesh? Uttarakhand, please, let's not troll me. Has Uttar Pradesh given a name?
Has the BJP given a UP?
Uttarakhand, in Uttarakhand to come
Sidhu.
Here to come here to
here.
Come here to come here and
the
to make points that are
here.
Irrelevant to come here
no.
and
no,
make
no,
points
no.
that are irrelevant
okay.
it's
no,
fine
it is, it
the
is.
Fact is Uttarakhand they have no face Uttarakhand they have no face
you have to concede that point Rajagopalan you have to concede that point the topic yeah the topic is Sidhu here but if you're questioning the fact that the Congress has not announced a chief ministerial face in Punjab well the BJP has not announced one in Uttar Pradesh either and I think yeah Shahid Siddiqui and RP Singh Shahid Siddiqui so the question here is now what's exactly happening here is it is the BJP regretting what's happened with Navjot Singh Sidhu is the Congress realizing perhaps this is the extra shot in the arm that they needed is Sidhu realizing that he had run out of options and therefore he decided to come to the Congress what's exactly happening here Shahid Siddiqui
No, it's, I don't know what Sidhu realized, but it is very clear that Sidhu knows that Captain Amrinder Singh is not on very happy terms with Rahul Gandhi. He never was. In fact, he had to put his foot down and he had to really threaten that he will leave the party when he was made the party president. And now on every seat, there's a tussle between the Congress leadership and Captain Amrinder Singh. Hmm. He's putting his foot down. He's not allowing the seats which Rahul wanted and that has been the tussle and that's why it is taking long to decide the seats and Sidhu knows that if in that kind of tussle he may gain he may become the chief minister even if he does not become the chief minister Captain Amrinder Singh is too old he may not be there for long
but
and
Sidhu,
there Sidhu will have an opportunity so Sidhu has taken
party.
Decision looking at everything
saying?
But there is a problem in within Congress there is a huge
yes,
problem
from,
within
from
the Congress
from a political expert point of
no,
view
no,
Mr. Shahid Siddiqui isn't that detrimental
just
for
one
the Congress
point?
Party they're
point?
Not in the best of the places right now when it comes to Punjab or any other state Now, at such a point, to have two of your big faces, Captain Amrinder and Sidhu, not on the same page. I mean, one of the reasons why they took so long to come out and make the announcement
I
was
agree,
this problem.
Absolutely.
And that's just going to become more and more detrimental as we, you know, get closer to the election
agree.
Day.
No, but Rahul wanted a young face. To counter counter Captain Amrinder Singh, and that may be the one of the reasons that the Rahul group
saab,
wanted Sidhu to come in the party.
Siddiqui saab, may I just make a point? As so far as Punjab is concerned, I know this as a fact. The Congress has a fantastic young leadership. There's Raja Brar. There are a lot of young leaders who are in Congress. So you know, Congress with young leadership. Is it has a good young leadership, a lot of youth Congress have
so
got
Congress
tickets.
Fantastic leadership all over the country, no doubt about that.
If Congress has such great young leadership, I don't know why they would have chased Sidhu and given whatever he wanted, you know, to this extent. So let's not go around on a campaigning mode here. If Congress really had such great stars, but Sabha, before I go across to RP Singh on this point as well, what the point that you were also adding on to. This is just going to get more detrimental and why doesn't, you know, whether it's the Rahul camp or the rest of the leadership get it?
Look, you know, as somebody else said in the beginning of the program,
and
the fight is fundamentally, this is between the Aam Aadmi Party and the Congress with BJP at number three. Let me finish. BJP Akalis at number three. Now, very curiously, Amrinder Singh is going to take on Prakash Singh Badal. He's going to get tied down in one debate. Secondly, when you bring in interlopers at the last minute, there is a lot of internal sabotage that goes on in parties. Amrinder Singh is a long old hand in the game of politics. I don't know. I don't know right now. I haven't been to Punjab yet. How cohesively they're going to work? Whether you know, if he doesn't see his own interest, he has been there. So I don't know
but
what the Congress leadership
Sabha,
is doing.
Sabha, may I interject one second?
I think they're just
interject
sort of trying,
one second.
You know, yeah,
Amritsar was.
Yes.
Sabha,
please,
may I just interject? Amritsar was always Sidhu's seat.
Yeah.
To say Sidhu's been parachuted from top is not sure. It was this time Captain won against Jaitley, but it's always been Sidhu's seat. Sidhu has a charisma there, so you're not getting Sidhu and parachuting him from the top. Let's be clear on that as well, Sabha.
Yeah,
no, that's
only
very true.
Yeah.
So is he only for Amritsar?
No, that's the point.
I agree. But I'm making another point.
We'll look at it when we get to
just arising from the point that Sabha was making, RP Singh. Now, you know, the fact is, you may just dismiss Sidhu, you may call him an egotist, you may call him whatever you want, but he does please crowds. He is popular. You cannot deny that. And are you going to completely write away what Navjot Singh Sidhu can do for the Congress party in Punjab? Are you going to completely deny his popularity?
Okay, let me define it like this. Popularity doesn't turn into votes. And in Delhi, he campaigned for me. He came for my campaigning for me also in my constituency. But that didn't turn into votes. So people come to hear a man because he can draw crowd, he can crack some jokes, but it doesn't turn into vote. And I'm telling you, give me a minute, please. I'm telling you, on 4th of March, I'll sit in your channel only, and you'll hear the result from East Amritsar, where he'll lose, he'll be dragged badly by our local man, Honey there. Wait for the time. Because people of Punjab knows that Sidhu is not going to deliver. He's going to again ditch them and go back to his shows. And being an MLA is a hard work. It's a tough work. You can't simply ditch your people and go back to shows. And people are going to vote for someone who's not going to work for them.
Singh Saab, if you knew he wasn't going to work, why did you offer him the Rajya Sabha? Why were you all cheating the people of Punjab if he was such a turncoat, runaway, would go to his comedy shows?
Rajya Sabha is an easy post. Rajya Sabha is not answerable to electorate. Rajya Sabha is not answerable to electorate.
So it's okay.
Here he'll be answerable to electorate now.
Rajagopalan, please.
There are lots of internal contradictions in Punjab Congress.
Mr.
Sidhu joined Congress, why Punjab leaders were not present in the meeting? Today, Mr. Sidhu is taking on Mr. Amarinder Singh. There is a old versus young.
Mr. Rajagopalan, don't divert from the topic right now. The comment that RP Singh made, Mr. Ketkar, then for what was BJP doing all these years? Exactly. They made him an MP of Rajya Sabha. It's okay, Mr. RP Singh.
But
it's okay if you don't have time for Rajya Sabha.
And if Amarinder Singh and Sidhu fight, that is their problem. It is not a question of Amarinder's fight. It is not a question of everyday issues. Fact is, Sidhu has left BJP and joined Congress on the eve of elections, realizing that Modi and BJP cards are not working. The decline has begun. If the decline had not begun, he would have stayed. And if he is okay in Rajya Sabha as an egotist and a confused person, why should not be okay for assembly? It is absolutely absurd to say that he doesn't want to work. And because it doesn't want to work, you send
him to Rajya Sabha.
Allow him to respond. Yes, RP Singh.
As I was telling, assembly elections are different from Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha, you're not answerable to electorate. In assembly, you are answerable to electorate for 24 hours. Any electorate can call you from grace to electricity to water to school to admission to college to hospital. For everything you're answerable. And people expect you to be there to helping them. And he's not going to be there for people. He said, he has on record said that I'm not going to do my shows. I'll be there in Bombay. So people know in that constituency that his wife was available, but he won't be available. And if he thinks he can do with his wife and his wife can play his role in his absence, then people are going to vote for him.
The official position of the BJP that in the Rajya Sabha you are not answerable to the electorate. Is this the official position of the BJP? Because if this is Tina, this is breaking news.
Yes,
this is the position of the BJP.
On day to day,
is this your official position?
Tell me which Rajya Sabha member parliament
is your official position?
Yes, on day to day affair. Are you joking? Which Rajya Sabha member parliament is answerable for day to day affair?
Sorry, official position of the BJP.
From his daily affairs, which Rajya Sabha member parliament is answerable for that? Yes, only people get
so. So your position is.
They are MLAs and they are answerable to MLAs.
Sir, yes, Piyush Goyal has no conscience to cater to. He is answerable to his ministry. But people who comes from the electoral politics have to deal differently. And now, Mr. Sidhu,
Mr. Arpi saying the assembly or the lower house or the upper house, I don't think any voter is going to buy this logic of yours that they don't have to spend equal amount of time. Yes, at the end of the day, they're all representatives of the people. But we're completely out of time on this debate. And the only thing I want to tell our viewers is that viewers, when it comes to politics of opportunism and convenience, it's not restricted to one leader. It is not restricted to one party. For decades now, we've seen the Congress, the BJP, and all of these regional parties resort to this kind of politics of opportunism. But is it fair? Is it fair on you, the voter, when one person abandons their ideology, one person abandons their style of politics just for the power and for that one chair? That is for the viewers to decide, for the voters to decide and tell their leaders. That's up to you to decide tonight. Thank you so much to all our panelists on behalf of Tina and me for joining us on the News Hour Debate.